Hi everyone, Miss Janine here, your grade 7 science teacher. For our today's science tutorial, we will discuss heat. Are you ready to learn with me? Let's start! What do you usually do to keep your body temperature constant during cold and hot days? During cold days, you tend to wear thick clothing and sip a hot cup of coffee. While during hot days, you wear thin clothing and enjoy drinking cold beverages. Why is that so? Particles in matter are constantly moving. In solids, they move back and forth. In liquids, they slide and pass one another, while in gases, particles move rapidly in all directions. These particles in matter exhibits both kinetic and potential energy. The total energy of the particles of matter is called as the thermal energy. When you hold a cup of coffee and an ice cream, you can sense how hot or cold they are. This sensation is associated with temperature. We say that an object has a higher temperature if it is hot. On the other hand, cold object has a lower temperature. Temperature refers to how hot or cold an object is. There are three temperature scales that we are using. These scales were proposed by the following people: Anders Celsius, Daniel Gabriel Fahrenheit, and Lord Kelvin. Let's say that we have a kettle and a glass full of boiling water at 100 degrees Celsius. Both have the same temperature, but they have different thermal energy. Note that the kettle has more water, which means that it has more particles. And more particles mean that it has more thermal energy. Heat is the energy transferred from one body to another due to a temperature difference. For example, when you hold an ice, there is a difference in temperature between your hand and the ice. Your hand has a higher temperature compared to the ice. Your hand starts to transfer heat to the ice until your hand and the ice reach the same temperature. That is called as the thermal equilibrium. Remember that the heat always moves from higher to lower temperature. There are three modes of heat transfer. First is what we call as the conduction. It is the transfer of energy from one material to another through direct contact. For example, heat is transferred from the flame to the bottom of the casserole, to the handle, and lastly to your hand through direct contact. This transfer of energy by particles of matter bumps to each other. Some materials do not allow energy to transfer. These are called as insulators. Another mode of heat transfer is convection. This is the transfer of energy by the circulation or movement of a liquid or gas. When energy is added to a fluid, the particles move faster. In this example, the heated water in the casserole expands and becomes less dense. This less dense water rises, while the cooler, denser water sinks. This movement creates convection currents. Energy is transferred by this current from warmer to the cooler part of the liquid. The third mode of heat transfer is radiation. This is the transfer of energy through electromagnetic waves. The heat from the flame reaches your hand even though there is no direct contact. The heat travels through waves. That's it! Let's have a quick recap. In this video, we discuss heat, the difference between thermal energy and temperature, the temperature scales by Celsius, Fahrenheit, and Kelvin, and the modes of heat transfer. Now, let's try answering a 5-item quiz about heat. You have a minute to answer. Good luck! Time's up. Let's check if your answers are correct. That's the end of our science tutorial. I hope that you've learned a lot and see you soon. Thank you for watching.